You are standing in front of the core of the B reactor. This is the heart of the operation, where a chain reaction transforms uranium into plutonium. Construction of the core of the reactor was an incredible undertaking. Tens of thousands of pieces had to be fit together to exacting specifications to make sure that the reactor would run smoothly.
The reactor core front face has 2004 process tubes. Inside the process tube, you'll find fuel elements. Those fuel elements are natural uranium or slightly enriched. They're each 1.5 inches in diameter by 8.7 inches long. That's a standard fuel element. There are 32 of those per process tube. There are 16 spacers on the front that are basically just aluminum spacers.
To keep the rate of reaction under control, the process tubes were encased in a 36 by 29 foot lattice of graphite, standing on a 28 foot thick concrete base. Compounding the difficulty was the fact that each block of graphite had to be individually drilled and then stacked by hand, with very little tolerance for error. In addition to the holes for the 2004 process tubes, the graphite also had to have space for 29 vertical safety rods, 9 horizontal control rods, and a cooling system.
So we have a basically inner core of 75,000 blocks with holes bored in every direction you can think of, top, bottom, side, left, and front and back. What were they using? Bricklayers is what did it. They put chalk strings across, they laid them in, they stacked them.
This inner core is surrounded by a wall of cast iron blocks as a safety or thermal shield. These blocks absorb 97% of the gamma radiation emitted from the core. In addition, there is a biological shield that is outside of the core to protect workers in the area.
Well, there's 52 inches of laminated steel and masonite. Then on the outside of that, there's a 1-inch thick boilerplate that encloses the whole thing, makes it gas tight.
Intense heat is generated inside the core when nuclear reactions take place. To make sure that the heat did not destroy the reactor, a complex cooling system was developed. The large vertical tubes you see on either side of the reactor face carried cooling water to the spiral pigtails, which lead into the reactor core.
That water is basically comes out of the Columbia River and then pumped to the 190. The 190 is the pressure pumping. That water then comes out of the 190, feeds up to the headers, through the cross headers, which are 42 of them, through the pigtail nozzles, and into each process tube. Basically, the flow splits the 27,000 gallons per minute, and each provides to the core area, which is their hottest area, a higher flow than in the perimeters around the outside because they don't produce as much heat. The water that flows through there takes about a second from the time it enters the process tube until it's discharged out the back.
With precise construction and imaginative design, the reactor core you see before you was truly a marvel of engineering.